I'm Ramon Clara, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. getting his wish fulfilled for a bilateral meeting with U.S. President Joe Biden on Wednesday afternoon in New York. The two world leaders are meeting for the first time on the sidelines of the United Nations General Assembly. They're expected to discuss how to continue to strengthen ties between the Philippines and the U.S., two longtime allies, particularly in areas of trade and investments. Meanwhile, according to the UN, Marcos met with UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres on Tuesday. Both reportedly discussed areas of cooperation and support, as well as views on the international situation and climate action initiatives. Speaking of climate change, during his UN General Assembly, Marcos Jr. called on world leaders to immediately act on the issue, noting that the time to talk about it has already passed.
Climate change is the greatest threat affecting our nations and our peoples. There is no other problem so global in nature that it requires a united effort, one led by the United Nations.
Marcos says it is an injustice that countries that have contributed the least to the problem continue to suffer the most from climate change.
The Philippines, for example, is a net carbon sink. We absorb more carbon dioxide than we emit. And yet, we are the fourth most vulnerable country to the effects of climate change.
The Philippine leader says industrialized countries should immediately fulfill their obligations under the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change and the Paris Agreement to cut their greenhouse gas emissions, provide climate financing and technology transfer for adaption for the most vulnerable and developing countries to lead by example.
Never again! Never again!
As Marcos Jr. continues on with his week-long visit to the U.S., BLM activists took to the streets to remind people about the horrors the Philippines endured when martial law was declared by Marcos Jr.'s father, former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr., exactly 50 years ago. In Los Angeles, hundreds gathered at the historic Filipino town.
We're here to remember victims of martial law. People went missing. We're here to continue to fight that our parents have started, and it is our faith that compels us to join this fight.
Never again! Never again!
A similar protest took place in San Francisco, where Benji Pineda shared his experience during the martial law era as a student activist who protested against the Marcos regime. Although he was not tortured, Pineda says he was incarcerated for 2 years.
We were able to endure 2.5 years of imprisonment solely on the knowledge that we took the correct option against the dictatorship, and that there are a lot of people out there in the cities or even in the provinces who are supporting us, who are continuing the fight against the dictatorship.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TSC news on the ABS-CBN news website, news.abs-cbn.com/TSC news, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Cup of Million.